Good afternoon and welcome to Boston Asian Radio and TV English Daily News Today. I am your host, Amanda. Here's a look at the top stories making headlines today. SpaceX giant rocket fails minutes after launching from Texas. Biden preparing to announce reelection campaign as early as next week. Feds demand worker safety changes at MBTA, warning about substantial risk of death or injury. Cambridge company to begin offering wastewater monitoring for norovirus. 14-year-old boys accused of breaking into East Boston store, stealing cell phones and electronics. SpaceX giant rocket fails minutes after launching from Texas. SpaceX's Starship rocket, designed to carry people and cargo to the Moon and Mars, exploded and crashed into the Gulf of Mexico during its first test flight. The 400-foot rocket was supposed to peel away from the booster after takeoff, circle the Earth, and crash into the Pacific near Hawaii. The test flight was watched by a large crowd from Sao Padre Island. Starship is designed to be fully reusable and lower costs. Similar to SpaceX's smaller Falcon rockets, NASA has already reserved a Starship for its next moonwalking team, and rich tourists are booking lunar flybys. This was the second launch attempt after Monday's try was scrapped due to a frozen booster valve. Biden preparing to announce reelection campaign as early as next week. President Joe Biden is expected to announce his 2024 reelection campaign next week, on Tuesday, April 25, 4 years since he entered the 2020 race. Biden, who has repeatedly stated his intention to run for a second term, is expected to make the announcement in the form of a video released to supporters. Although he faces no significant opposition to his party's nomination, he will have to juggle running the country while campaigning. His priorities include implementing the infrastructure, technology investment, and climate laws passed during his first 2 years in office, and drawing a sharp contrast with Republicans over the nation's borrowing limit. Despite concerns about his age and fitness, aides say he plans to mount a robust campaign ahead of the close general election. Feds demand worker safety changes at MBTA, warning about substantial risk of death or injury. Federal regulators have threatened to block the MBTA from track work unless the agency takes immediate action to address safety incidents that have put T workers at risk. The Federal Transit Administration cited a combination of unsafe conditions and practices that have resulted in a substantial risk of death or injury. The MBTA has made some progress since a highly critical report last year, but gaps in safety oversight and training, as well as authority and responsibility for worker safety, persist. The FTA issued deadlines that the MBTA must meet to continue track work. The Massachusetts Department of Public Utilities also ordered safety briefings for employees and contractors and a safety refresher course for engineering and maintenance employees. Cambridge company to begin offering wastewater monitoring for norovirus. Cambridge-based company BioBot Analytics is expanding its wastewater monitoring program to include norovirus in addition to COVID-19. CEO Mariana Mattis said that monitoring wastewater for norovirus will help communities make informed public health decisions, as rates for the highly contagious virus continue to be at a yearly high across the U.S. According to the CDC, noroviruses are the leading cause of foodborne illness, with over 20 million illnesses every year, resulting in about $2 billion in lost productivity and healthcare expenses annually. BioBot Analytics estimated that monitoring norovirus in wastewater will provide equitable and inclusive data that can help public health officials prepare and respond more effectively to outbreaks. The program will be available to existing customers starting in May before it is opened up to other communities. 14-year-old boys accused of breaking into East Boston store, stealing cell phones and electronics. Two 14-year-old boys have been arrested for allegedly smashing the front windows of Celltronic Boston, a phone repair shop in East Boston, and stealing cell phones and electronics. The police were alerted after the business alarm did not activate when the suspects broke the glass. The suspects were caught on surveillance video taking multiple cell phones from a wall display and later breaking the glass counter to steal more. They returned 30 minutes later to steal more electronics. Police officers arrested the suspects and recovered 23 cell phones and 3 electronic watches. The teens are charged with delinquent to wit, breaking and entering, and receiving stolen property, and are expected to be arraigned in Boston Municipal Court. Stay tuned for more updates on Boston news as it develops.